not, they want to make a presentation. After they get through, we can have comments. And I ask you, if you will, everybody that wants to have a say, please limit it by 2 minutes. We have time. If you have a list and wants to speak, we'll try to give everybody an opportunity.
Can you see the backlights on too? Everybody still see that?
If anybody has any trouble seeing, I wonder. I don't know, we got a little bit of room to stand up here, I reckon. We're sending around a little good information as well. My name's Logan Stevens. This is my coworker, Stephen LaFleur. We're from O2 Energies. We're a solar developer based here in North Carolina, just north of Charlotte, in a town called Cornelius. Thank y'all for coming out today. This is one of the biggest crowds we've ever had, so it's good to see everybody. It's a bit different tonight than what we normally do, I guess, because this is a hearing on a zoning ordinance change and not a hearing on this particular project that we proposed here in town. So I'm really here just to, I guess, answer questions about solar in general, or we can answer questions specific to the project. The information related to the project's in the handout that's going around. But we do have a few slides here just about O2 Energies we can go through real quick. Like I said, we're based here in North Carolina, and all we do is develop, own, and operate these ground-mounted solar farms in the 1 to 20 megawatt range. We work with towns, cities, counties, contractors, which are mostly North Carolina-based, and hiring North Carolina local labor for all of our projects. We're with utilities here in the state. Here locally, it's Progress Energy. If you go a bit further north, you run into Dominion, who we work with as well. And again, we're focused on the southeast, and up to this point, all of our projects have been here in North Carolina. So we're happy to work in our home state where all of us are from, and try to keep it that way until we can't do any more here. So. Just a quick map of our projects. We own and operate 7 solar farms similar to these, all the way from the mountains in New England near Grandfather Mountain, all the way down to the East Coast. So we've got projects close by, and let's see, I guess the closest one's probably Elm City, which is close to Raleigh, about half an hour outside of Raleigh. We've also got 2 very close to each other in Robeson County, one in Fairmont, one in Maxson. Just a few pictures of our projects. We started out with these 3 early on. That's Avery there in the mountains. Mayberry on the right, which we worked with the city of Mount Airy to use a piece of land around their wastewater treatment plant that they hadn't been able to use for anything else. Sandy Cross Solar, which was a old piece of farmland. Couldn't really find a use for that either because the highway had come through and cut it off from the rest of the farm. So we're able to go in there and make use of that piece of property. This is Ararat Rock Solar, also in Mount Airy. The 2 that I mentioned that are down in Robeson County are Maxson Solar up there on the right and Fairmont Solar down there on the left, which is inside the town limits of Fairmont. It's right beside Fairmont High School. We had a great experience working with the town there. So I guess in order for us to do this project here in town, we've been in conversation with some folks for a couple of months now, and Brian Buck's been working on putting together an ordinance that would allow solar farms to happen inside the town. And that's what's on the agenda tonight to be heard. We've read through the ordinance and it looks great. We don't have any problems with it. I think what we've proposed will meet or exceed all the requirements of the ordinance. But just a few details about the project. This specific project is a 5-megawatt solar farm. And its project cost is roughly $13 million all altogether. About $10 million of that is the hard cost for the equipment and everything. The state has a 80% property tax abatement, so 20% of that hard cost is what would go on the books. So roughly $2 million would be added to the property tax base. And what we've sort of proposed is, if we were able to get control of this property, we would ask to be voluntarily annexed by the town, so that the town would receive that property tax revenue rather than the county. It's a 77-acre piece of land, and we would be looking to use roughly 35 acres of that inside the fence. The remainder we would probably keep wooded where it's wooded, but the open part we would certainly be willing to use for future residential development. That's all the road frontage right along Braggall Lane there as you go down the road. So we have no issues with that. And one thing that we have proposed as well is to put in a vegetated screen in between that area and the solar farm, so that it basically wouldn't be able to be seen from the road. You got some pictures in your handout of what that would kind of look like, looking from the road, from the entrance, and from the neighborhood. Yeah, they're up here as well. So once the farm is built, kind of look across an empty field, but eventually this empty field could be subdivided and turned into residences in the future. One of the things in the ordinance is requires some setbacks from property lines, from roads, and from residential structures and commercial structures. I think those are 50 feet and 100 feet for those. So we've just shown here that the solar farm would be at a minimum 300 feet from the road, 715 feet to the nearest residence, and 730 feet to the next closest residence. So we're really trying to use the piece of the property that's far away from the road and from any houses. The only place you'd be able to see it really is from Highway 17 bypass for about 10 seconds to drive by. Otherwise, doesn't make any noise, doesn't make any smell, doesn't cause any glare, doesn't create any radiation or anything. So if you didn't know it was there, you probably would never see it, except for driving past it on the bypass. We've got a couple of pictures here. I think some of these are in your slides as well. Just what a solar farm looks like from ground level. As you can see, the grass comes in and we maintain the grass so that it looks nice throughout the year. It's a low impact development, so we're not pouring any concrete. There's no impervious surface. All the water can just go right into the ground. So it's, in terms of commercial type uses, it's about as low impact as it gets. We won't have a parking lot or anything there. So again, just the benefits to Chappaquiddick, we're talking about an increase to the property tax base, local economic development, in that we source all the labor here locally, either from the town or from the county. Job creation during construction, workforce training for people that need it, get them up to speed to work on the project. And then, of course, we're here working with everybody that we can work with to make this a success here in the community. And I guess the one other thing we should add to that slide is that this particular property, as I understand it, has not been able to sell for a while because the property owner has not wanted to subdivide it. So all of that land is sort of zoned residential, hasn't been able to be used as a residential. But again, that's extra acreage for us that we won't be building on, so we'd be happy to subdivide that to be used for residences in the future. So hopefully that wasn't too long. Again, I guess what the order of the day is today is to talk about the ordinance, but just want to give you a bit of backdrop, I guess, with a particular project, so if you have any questions, we can answer those questions.